the family situation can be either, for example, spouses or partners of someone with hoarding, or adult children who may not live in the home but have visited the parent who has a hoarding problem. Those are probably the two most common situations that family members encounter. And it's quite challenging for them. If they're living in the home with someone who's got a hoarding problem, then the odds are high that there's a fair amount of conflict and tension about how far the stuff has spread and whether or not it's impinging on the partner's ability to use the home as they would like to do it. In the case of adult children for hoarding who have visited and perhaps grew up in a home that was hoarded, but now are coming in later in their lives and seeing that it has expanded, the clutter has expanded, is starting to get very dangerous for their parent. And they are the ones who often call with great concern about what to do next in order to prevent something that's quite dangerous from happening. Often the loved one is resistant, the parent is resistant, especially when a child is telling them what to do and they've reversed the roles that they used to have. There's a temptation on the part of any family member to want to just clear it out. If they themselves have the skills to organize clutter and put it away, they're very tempted to want to come over and either throw things out that they know they consider to be trash, or to organize it all in a way that makes sense to them. And the problem with those strategies is that that doesn't give the person with the hoarding problem a chance to learn any new skills. So the problem is just going to happen all over again. In addition to that, one of the real challenges is that a family member who comes in and waits till the person with hoarding has left the home and then cleans it out or has it cleaned out, the relationship between those two people will inevitably be almost destroyed because the trust is gone. So that's one of the most serious consequences of family members trying to intervene before it makes sense for them to try to do that. We certainly understand that family members will want to consult with someone who's knowledgeable about hoarding. They'll want to read about it, and there's some very good resources out there for them. And as they do that, for example, the IOCDF website has a number of articles on hoarding itself to understand it, as well as articles on what a family member could do in these most difficult situations where there is some significant danger to the loved one.